Hey guys, and welcome to another Game Explained discussion. I'm your host, Andre Seegers, and this time we're joined by Colin McIsaac from Gamnesia to discuss a potentially new Kirby stage coming to Smash Bros. Wii U. So let's get started. Alright, Colin, so this is a huge surprise. In fact, I don't even know if it's supposed to be out.
Yeah, I'll say. I mean, so basically how this was released was on the Super Smash Bros. Official Facebook page, they released an image that says, "This Week in Super Smash Bros." And it looks like they have a picture of the orbital gate that they posted on Miiverse last week. And next to it, they have a completely new picture that maybe they were planning to post on Miiverse last week and they didn't. And I don't know, it's all very confusing, but it says "This Week in Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS." So I'm sitting here thinking, what is going on?
Well, and not just that, the caption for the picture itself, like posted to Facebook, it says, "Here are some highlights of what we shared this week." So it's
exactly
clearly talking about the past tense. But yeah, they didn't show off this image, so...
Yeah, so, like, so, I mean, someone screwed up.
Yeah, so whatever, though, it's awesome, but it gives us something to talk about.
Absolutely.
And I have a feeling this may have pushed up maybe their plan of when they actually will talk about the stage for real. Maybe it'll even be tonight's picture of the day. Right. So yeah, let's get to the stage itself. So now, the picture itself also has its own caption, and it says, "Kirby's going for a ride in a minecart." Well, this situation looks familiar. The stage has some rules that are rare in the Smash Bros. Series. And then the picture itself shows Kirby and Pikachu riding in a minecart. Now, at first glance, this doesn't look like anything familiar, but luckily I played a bunch of, you know, at least the older Kirby games, and this minecart looks like it's ripped right from the Great Cave Offensive. So the fact that we have Kirby in here and, you know, riding in a minecart from that game, which itself was part of Kirby Superstar, makes me think that this level is based on, you know, the Great Cave Offensive, especially because there's a castle in the background, and there's also a castle in that mode as well. So that's all kind of interesting.
Yeah, absolutely, and I'm entirely convinced that this has got to be the new Kirby stage for Smash Bros. Wii U, because we haven't seen a new one yet. We've seen the Battleship Halberd coming back from Brawl, but we haven't seen an entirely new Kirby stage, and... You know, at first I saw the minecart, I was thinking, like, is this Donkey Kong? It doesn't really look like it's designed like Donkey Kong. And I also was thinking of the minecarts from the Subspace Emissary. You know, you sort of hop in, it brings you a certain distance and then sort of stops, and I forget, it might explode a little bit. But yeah, then you pointed out it has the same design as the one from the Great Cave Offensive, and the yellow sort of border you can see on the bottom of the screenshot there, it looks a lot like the way that the Great Cave Offensive levels are designed, so... I'm pretty convinced that's what this has got to be.
Now the question is, how is a stage going to work? If it is in fact a stage, and we'll get more on that in a sec here. But, you know, looking at this picture, there's not really much to glean from it. There's a minecart, there's a castle in the background, and I think you can maybe see another platform above and to the right there.
Yeah, very, very... It's very small, and it's hard to tell exactly if that's just a single platform or if that's like another structure entirely that you can only get
right.
a glimpse of.
So the thing is, like, with the minecarts in the Great Cave Offensive, first off, they weren't even a big part of that mode, as I remember. You came across them a couple times, and just in a short sequence, but you would hop in, and you could have your CPU or your human, you know, partner hop in with you as well, two people basically, as you see here, and you would just go for a ride. You can drop off ledges in it, and otherwise you couldn't do anything else but jump out of the minecart.
Yeah, it wasn't nearly as active as like other games like the Donkey Kong Country series, and I think Yoshi's New Island even has some minecart levels where you can there's action happening that's beyond just, you know, sitting in a minecart and moving.
Right, I mean, that's it. I guess the one thing you could do is it just let you just run through enemies. You know, like enemies just spawn in front of you, just run them over. So in which case, I could see this being a pretty freaking awesome hazard, actually. If you could if you caught a ride in a minecart, maybe it'll give you a KO for anyone you take out in it.
Yeah, no, that would be really cool.
Yeah.
What I'm really wondering about how this stage might work is, so like, you know, in the Great Cave Offensive, like you said, it's not based around minecarts. Minecarts are a very small portion of the entire sort of minigame. So I'm wondering if this is going to be more like one of those tour stages, you know,
right.
like Skyloft and Mario Sunshine and Mute City. But I'm wondering if the minecart is the way you get from stage to stage, and if this is just another series of platforms constructed like the Great Cave Offensive.
Oh, that's an interesting idea. It's possible, in which case I guess there'd have to be multiple minecarts to hold all the players, or maybe they can all pile into one. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it's very hard to tell in this, because obviously it could be in that this is just a two-player match right there.
Right.
But it also could be that there's a limit of two players in a single minecart, and, you know, it's just very hard to tell from the one picture what it could possibly, you know, have in store.
Yeah, I mean, it's more exciting with just how much potential there is here, and I think you hit on something with the idea of it being a traveling stage to some extent.
Yeah.
Because the thing with the Great Cave Offensive is it was a big mode. Like, you explored a giant map. It was basically Metroid Lite. Like, you were Kirby, you could explore this...
It's a good way to describe it.
Right? You could explore this, you know, large world. And so it would be, you know, so I feel like this level has to represent more than just a small section of that, being the minecart section.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's either going to be, you travel from part to part, you know, to different parts of the world, as you did in the level itself. Or maybe this is really just one giant map, similar in scale to Palutena's Temple, which is gigantic in scale, and I could see them doing something like that here, where maybe this is just a very small part of the level, especially with, you know, it looks like they're not doing anything, like, super crazy in this, you know, one area, like, visually, so it would make sense for it to be represented as a small portion of what is otherwise a much larger stage.
Yeah, and because Great Cave Offensive had so many different, like, level themes blended into that single world, I can definitely see this taking the form of, you know, a massive, massive stage, where, you know, if you look at Palutena's Temple, part of it has, like, the goddess statue, part of it has this sort of, like, underground area, part of it has, like, another temple area. There are lots of different sort of stage themes, almost, that come together in one place.
Right.
And I think that could be, they might be doing something similar.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
Now, have you been keeping up with the Tower of Smash rumor, by the way?
Yes, I have. I generally don't believe text-only leaks very much. Of course, with Onet and Smashville and the gamer stage from Game & Wario, I've definitely been thinking about it a lot more. And I actually originally was wondering if this minecart area might be part of the Tower of Smash, where you sort of go from battle to battle riding on a minecart or something like that.
That's the only way we could really reconcile this with the leak, because the leak had three Kirby stages on there, three new Kirby stages, being Kooky Country, Mount DDD, and Patchland. And as far as we can gather, this stage doesn't match any of those, unless it's part of a larger Kirby stage, like Mount DDD. But that really does seem to be a stretch.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't really fit with the theme of... Because this is... I mean, as far as I'm concerned, this is definitely the Great Cave Offensive.
Right.
I can't imagine... I mean, it could be a sort of a Kirby tour stage, and this is a sort of Great Cave Offensive stop.
Right.
Where Mount DDD is included, some other stuff like that.
Yeah, so, I mean, that would seem to, unfortunately, disprove the leak, because the leak was looking pretty good for a while.
Yeah, I know.
However, I do have one idea that could save it, and I'm not saying it just to save the leak. I had this idea separately. I think the idea by itself could be awesome. With that said, I think the leak probably is dead, but whatever.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I don't really see it.
So, here's my idea. So, before we did this discussion, I actually went through and played through some of the Great Cave Offensive, just to give myself a refresher of it. And as I was playing it, I'm like, man, this feels a lot like Smash Brothers. Like how, you know, the simplistic controls, Kirby can shield in it, very similar to Smash Brothers.
Yeah, exactly. I was playing through, like, Amazing Mirror a couple months ago, and I remember thinking, like, oh my god, I don't remember this game being the Subspace Emissary on the Game Boy Advance.
Well, and so like, that's what I'm wondering. So, you know, looking at Smash Brothers 3DS, you know, its big mode is Smash Run, and that was based on Kirby Air Ride City Trial. And then I'm playing through Great Cave Offensive, and I'm thinking... What if this could be the new mode for Smash Bros. Wii U single player? What if they have a Great Cave Offensive, you know, mode, which would be based on the Kirby game, just as, you know, Smash 3DS's, you know, one-player mode is based on the Kirby game? I think it would make a ton of sense, you know, given that, you know, you'd be exploring this massive world. It would actually be like Subspace Emissary with, you know, no story, and just, you know, more polished, where you're exploring, you know, this giant map, you're going around looking for treasure. And in Great Cave Offensive, some of that treasure is even themed to other Nintendo games. Like, you would find, like, I think a Triforce.
Oh, that's true.
Right? Or a Metroid. I think Sam has a Screw Attack symbol.
Mm-hmm.
So it would tie in perfectly, especially because in one part, you're, like, there's parts in the game where you can climb ladders.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can also climb ladders in Smash Bros. Brawl, including a Subspace Emissary. What if, basically, this is a replacement for Subspace Emissary?
Yeah, no, I mean, that's sort of what I was... I mean, my idea wasn't nearly as full-fleshed as that, but...
But you touched on it,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, exactly. And so I definitely think that could be really exciting and really cool, and I would absolutely love to, you know, if you could go through the different treasure rooms and unlock, like, trophies, custom moves. By the way, this would be a great way to put every single custom move in one map and go explore the rooms and get them all and not have to deal with repeats. I hate that so much
right.
in Smash 3DS. But I also don't really want to get my hopes that high up, because the image does say it's a stage, and that could be like a translation difference.
Right.
But I don't want to get too caught up in fantasy here.
I know, but I'm actually kind of excited about this idea.
Yeah,
now.
Me too.
It's probably not true at all.
Oh, I'm gonna be so mad if it's not true.
Right?
Thank you, Andre.
I know. I'm sorry, dude. I apologize in advance. But it makes so much sense, particularly as Subspace Emissary was also two player.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it was Great Cave Offensive. And on top of it all, as I was playing through it, there are these before you reach a boss, you reach these rooms where you can switch between different Kirby powers.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that's something that would seem like it would just make so much sense for Smash Brothers, whether you could switch between sets of maybe custom characters,
right,
or you switch to a whole different character in general. Like, maybe you go to that room, it gives you a few different characters to choose between, and you swap between characters to take on the boss.
Yeah, absolutely, and that feels very similar to the Subspace Emissary in the sense that, between stages or before boss fights, you would choose your roster of, three or four characters. I mean, number would vary depending on the stage,
right,
but the core idea there is the same. And I think that would be really exciting. And it would make a lot of sense to have another Subspace Emissary sort of mode. Because, Sakurai said that the main reason they weren't doing a story mode is because the cutscenes. That's right.
Right.
The cutscenes would be leaked online, and people would be able to watch the cutscenes without playing the game. And, I can imagine them doing a mode that's a lot like the Subspace Emissary, but completely void of a storyline and just about the gameplay, just about the exploration, about the treasure hunting, about the combat, about the riding minecarts from stage to stage. And that would be really, really cool, I think. And it would make a lot of sense.
It would. Because he hasn't talked at all about single-player modes. This really, of anything, would make the most sense, given the Kirby connection. We know Sakurai's
right.
Big on Kirby. So... So yeah, I really do hope that's the case.
Yeah.
Well, do you have any final thoughts at all, Colin, on whether on this being a stage or a mode? Anything else you want to talk about?
Again, I think it's a stage. I really, really want it to be a mode because that's just such a good idea
it
you
is.
Have there.
I know.
But yeah, I think it's a stage. It is a little weirdly cryptic though, about whether it's a stage or just what it even is at all.
Right.
So it maybe could be a teaser at some sort of single player thing. But
yeah.
Ultimately, I think it's probably just a Great Cave Offensive stage. I think it probably means the Tower Smash leak is not creditable.
Well, that's an offensive idea to me.
Ooh. Oh my god.
I know, I had to go there. That's it. I mean, if this is a stage, that basically disproves the leak. If
yeah.
it's a mode, the leak's still alive.
Right.
But with that said, based off everything we have, it doesn't appear to be a stage.
Yeah.
Either way, I'm excited for it. Great Cave Offensive is awesome. I love Superstar. Any representation that game gets is great, and I'm excited to see more of it.
Yeah, me too, absolutely. I mean, that's basically echoes all of my sentiments about it. I loved Superstar. I loved Superstar Ultra. Great Cave Offensive was my favorite mode in that game.
Yep.
And I would be super stoked to see a sort of HD remaster of Great Cave Offensive with all these Nintendo characters. And that music, oh my god.
Oh, can you imagine a remake
so
of that?
So good.
Oh, man. Fantastic.
That's, I'm really hoping it is a sort of Great Cave Offensive mode for Smash Bros.
Dude, I apologize to everyone for getting your hopes up, but this does not turn
You're
out to be true.
You're apologizing to a lot of people here, Andre.
I know. All right, well, I think that wraps it up for us here, so thanks for watching, and thanks for joining us, Colin.
Yeah, absolutely, anytime. Thank you.
Yeah, make sure to check out Colin.